On behalf of the Westlake High School Class of 2017, I would like to thank Mrs. Lisinski, the Board of Education, and Superintendent Galvin, and formally accept our diplomas. At this time, I would also like to invite my friend Isabel Palmer to the podium. Isabel is the president of the class, vice president of Key Club, secretary of Company D, co-president of National Honor Society, co-Relay for Life chair, writer for the school newspaper, and was involved in Leadership Challenge, SAD, and Debonairs. Isabel is the daughter of Andrea Rocco and Phil Palmer. Isabel will be attending The Ohio State University in the fall and will be majoring in Human Resources and Marketing. Brace yourself, people, because I'm about to start off my speech with a very cliche statement. Class of 2017, we finally made it. Now that that's out in the open, I will get down to the nitty-gritty. It's been an exciting 4 years. You all know the brilliant things you did that you will never forget, and even the things you might regret. But that's what life's about, the experiences, that is, both the good and the bad. And high school is just one stepping stone in this learning process we call life. Instead of reflecting solely on the past, I feel the need to address the future as well. After all, we are here today because we value the possibilities our futures hold. Starting out as freshmen, I don't think many of us knew what to expect. We were in a completely new school surrounded by kids who were twice as tall as us. We didn't know how to act, and we didn't know the lowdown on any of the teachers and staff. Granted, it didn't take very long to figure out that Mrs. Frazier knows everything, that Ms. Clark and Mrs. Norrin have anything you could possibly need, that Mrs. Reichert is always up for a good laugh, as sarcasm is her forte, that Bert is Mr. Curtis's spirit animal, and that Mr. Cuomo is the man. We eventually caught on to the tricks and secrets behind a successful high school career. I believe success is best represented by our win over last year's seniors in tug-of-war during class Olympics. Their defeat wasn't as bad as the Warriors blowing a 3-1 lead, but still, talk about a comeback. Altogether, the ups and downs of high school have prepared us for what lies ahead. There are three principles that I believe sum up what each and every one of us should focus on for the rest of our lives. Be fearless, be curious, be smart. Ask yourself this: what would you do if you knew you couldn't fail? You would do anything. Risks are sometimes rewarded. Don't be intimidated to go after what you want. We all want to be accepted, but once we realize that the need for wanting to fit in blocks for the potential for greatness, only then can we thrive. With that being said, don't be afraid to be yourself. One of the great things about high school is that despite our differences, whether based on culture, race, beliefs, or gender, we all want the same thing. We all want to be happy. I think high school has taught us that we shouldn't be afraid to find beauty within. Be fearless. We shouldn't settle for mediocre. Administrators and teachers have made it a point to assert the ideal of striving for greatness. Question how far you can push yourself to become a better person. Many of us are going to college where we will be thrown curveballs left and right. We must remain determined in order to experience the best outcome. We don't know how much time we have on this earth, so live every day as if it is your last. Be curious about the world and how you can create a change in the world. Be curious about how you can influence another person's life. Be curious enough to yearn to understand people and topics you didn't care to appreciate before. Ask questions. If you are curious, you will become more knowledgeable and stronger as an individual. Be curious. Being smart is much more than just being book smart, although that's definitely not a bad thing. By being smart, you gain a deeper understanding of the beautiful aspects of life. Put 110% effort into everything you do because it will pay off. Just look at our class as an example. We are all here today because we put in the hard work. We have classmates who will be enrolled in Ivy League schools, who will be participating in accelerated medical programs, who will be playing sports for their respective colleges. Our classmates are aspiring scientists and musicians, engineers, writers, artists, professors, and movie directors. We were smart when we recognized we needed to work hard to accomplish our goals. We are all capable of doing something better than anyone, to the best of our ability, better than anyone else in the world. So what is your thing? Find your genius, find your thing, be smart. As a whole, we've learned and experienced a great deal, and the opportunities our futures hold are limitless. I'll end my speech by reiterating the three principles I find most influential. Be fearless, be curious, be smart. If we embrace these ideals, the future better watch out, because they have some extraordinary people ready to take life head on. Thank you and congrats, grads.